take a little look on our grape arbor. My dad needs to start some pruning in a week or so. I want to get rid of some of the smaller canes like this one and this one. And tucked in some of the better ones on the arbor. So I'm gonna give you a quick tour under the canopy. Now during the growing season, it's all gonna be covered in leaves.
So this is the first week of April for the grapes right now. And they're gonna be needing a little of pruning. So pruning means, you know, like getting rid of the small pieces, make it a little bit cleaner. Okay, then we're also gonna leave the thicker ones. So let that grow bigger, and we're just gonna cut off tiny branches like these and stuff. With these, and so we take the thick ones. And what we do, we like kind of like when it's not dead, wrap it around so then the vine starts growing. So then it starts growing all on this. Generally, this right now looks pretty good. Right now, it's only first week, but. Sooner or later, it's gonna get better, and we're just gonna be tucking pieces like this so that the vines start growing through. These vines on the top grew all the way from the bottom, and we're hoping to get it all on here like last year, so when it grows, it's like a little hill of all leaves and all that.
Okay, so this is our grape arbor, and these we're gonna give it a little trim. So the vines that are less than pencil diameter, I'm gonna cut off and give it a little trim. So on the other larger vines, my dad will decide whether to cut them to give them a little trim or tuck them in. So let's start by cutting off the small ones. So since this one I think is thin, it goes all the way over here and up to here. This is where it starts off, so I'm gonna cut that piece. And it's gonna go right into my bucket. And since these are too thin, we're not gonna plant them. We're just gonna throw it away in my compost pile. So if you're a kid or parent, obviously if you're a parent, you can use these if you're safe enough and not clumsy. But if you're a child, make sure don't use this without your parents not looking. My dad gave me the permission to use these for this video. Okay, so this is tiny and I think I'm gonna cut it like right there. Okay. Bad kitty, no stopping. And I want to encourage new growth, so I'm going to cut it about right there. So here's some more, and I'm going to cut it right here. And later on, my dad could decide to do the finishing cuts. So here's another one, and I'm going to cut it about right here. Like Maui's hook. Cut it. Thank you. So these are how our grapes are doing, and you see those little buds? Those are gonna become grapes. So this is how our grape arbor is doing. Oh, my hair. Arbor is doing on June 18th.
It is November 10th, 2017. It's pretty cold out right now. It's about 19 degrees. And this is the first snowfall for the year. And today's the coldest that's been so far. Kind of neglected this arbor this year. As you can see, there's a lot of vines. It needs a lot of pruning. Hopefully in the next few days when it warms up a little bit, I can do some of the light pruning on the smaller canes that I really don't need. And then around April or May, I'm going to prune the larger canes that I want to repot and regrow. But you can see it's kind of wild. The ladders are going out. But it's too cold right now. My hands are freezing. And that's our first snowfall for the year.
So it's November 25th and we are going to prune the grape arbor. Some that are like this are less than pencil diameter, I'm going to cut them. And the longer ones my dad is probably going to tuck them in or cut them later on. So this is less than pencil diameter right here and I'm going to cut it. So these I'm also going to cut. So around April or May, my dad is going to cut the vines, but those are the ones that he's going to plant to grow. So as you can see over here, we have some wild vines that we are either going to tuck in or cut. Can't reach, my dad are going to cut them later on. So as you can see, we don't do your typical science pruning for grape arbors, but there's a lot of good videos about pruning the grape arbors, but we just eye it. So right now I'm pruning these small vines that cannot support fruit anymore. So I'm just gonna let my dad do the rest. So my dad is pruning and tucking the small vines in the grape arbor. And he's not cutting the big large vines because he's saving it to cut and kill in the summer. He's actually saving them so they can provide grapes. So we have some mini grapes down there and big grapes up there. Be aware if you come to my house and you go underneath there is fake stakes there. So like my hold on for dear life because my dad is taking a turn. Stop sitting. Okay. Yep, I'm so weird. Look, I can squish my dad. Like squishy, 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 squishy. My dad's all squishy.
That's how much we trimmed up. And as you can see, it looks cleaner. It's all cut. The smaller ones, smaller vines are all gone. And I'm gonna have to come back here in the spring and do a second trimming and tuck some of this stuff in back in the arbor. And some of these larger ones, they're good diameter vines. We're gonna cut them and regrow them. They're easy to grow. But as you can see from the inside, it looks really clean up above the canopy. And come May and June, it's gonna be full of foliage with some new growths. This is December 30th. It's very cold, it's -5 degrees right now. That's how the arbor is looking. Last time we did the video, I pruned this really nice, but I did leave some of the larger canes. They're at least pencil diameter. After the dormant season, around April or May, I'm gonna go ahead and cut those back even more. But the reason I saved those for April and May is that after I prune them, I'll stick them on a pot or soil so that they'll grow new vines and I can give those out to friends or replant them somewhere else. But it's looking good. Looks nice and trimmed. It's freezing.